Good morning, dear brothers and sisters. We are in the first day of the Holy Week. Let us prepare ourselves during this week that we may experience Christ's resurrection on the Easter Sunday. In the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 10, verse 38, we read, "When Jesus was passing through a village called Bethany, a woman named Martha welcomed Jesus into her house." That noble gesture of welcoming Jesus into their house transformed their lives forever. When Lazarus, their brother, was sick, they thought of Jesus. And when he was dead, in their moment of grief, Jesus was there. And in the Gospel today, we hear in a moment of their rejoicing, moment of their joy, after raising Lazarus from the dead, Jesus was there. Dear brothers and sisters, let us learn a lesson from Martha. Let us welcome Jesus into our lives, into our families, that this week may become a week of grace and blessing to all of us, that Jesus may become a friend of our lives, friend of our families, that he may bring life in abundance that he has promised into our lives during this Holy Week. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us come before the Lord with a sincere heart, recognizing we have failed to obey his holy will, and let us ask his mercy and forgiveness in order to celebrate this Holy Mass worthily. I confess to Almighty God and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us. May he forgive us our sins and lead us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that though in our weakness we fail, we may be revived through the passion of your only begotten Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Prophet Isaiah. Behold my servant, whom I uphold, my chosen, in whom my soul delights. I have put my spirit upon him. He will bring forth justice to the nations. He will not cry or lift up his voice or make it heard in the street. A bruised reed he will not break, and a dimly burning wick he will not quench. He will faithfully bring forth justice. He will not fail or be discouraged till he has established justice in the truth. And the coastlands wait for his law. Thus says the Lord, who created the heavens and stretched them out, who spread forth the earth and what comes from it, who gives breath to the people upon it and the spirit to those who walk in it. I am the Lord. I have called you in righteousness. I have taken you by the hand and kept you. I have given you as a covenant to the people, a light to the nations, to open the eyes that are blind, to bring out the prisoners from the dungeon, from the prison those who sit in darkness. the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response, the Lord is my light and my help.
The Lord is my light and my help.
The Lord is my light and my help. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Before whom shall I shrink? Response,
the Lord is my light and my help.
When evildoers draw near to devour my flesh, it is they, my enemies and foes, who stumble and fall. Response,
the Lord is my light and my help.
Though an army encamp against me, my heart would not fear. Though war break out against me, even then would I trust. Response,
the Lord is my light and my help.
I am sure I shall see the Lord's goodness in the land of the living. Hope in Him, hold firm and take heart. Hope in the Lord. Response,
the Lord is my light and my help.
Gospel acclamation. Hail our King, you alone have mercy on us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Chapter 12, verses 1 to 11. 6 days before the Passover, Jesus came to Bethany, where Lazarus was, whom he had raised from the dead. There they made him a supper. Martha served, and Lazarus was one of those at table with him. Mary took a pound of costly ointment of pure nard and anointed the feet of Jesus and wiped his feet with her hair. And the house was filled with the fragrance of the ointment. But Judas Iscariot, one of his disciples, he who was to betray him, said, "Why was this ointment not sold for 300 denarii and given to the poor?" This he said, not that he cared for the poor, but because he was a thief. And as he had the money box, he used to take what was put into it. Jesus said, "Let her alone. Let her keep it for the day of my burial. The poor you always have with you, but you do not always have me." When the great crowd of the Jews learned that he was there, they came not only on account of Jesus, but also to see Lazarus, whom he had raised from the dead. So the chief priest planned to put Lazarus also to death, because on account of him, many of the Jews were going away and believing in Jesus. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters, one of my friends used to say, always ask the why of what you do. If you know the reason of what we are doing, then we would always have that inner energy to do what we are doing. Always ask the why of what you do. If you ask Mary in the Gospel today, why did you pour out that costly ointment worth 300 denarii, maybe to our time something like 30,000 rupees, why did you pour it at the feet of Jesus? What would be her answer? I believe her answer would be, because I simply love Jesus. That was an act of love. In love, there is no counting the cost. Out of pure love for the Lord, she poured out that costly ointment at the feet of Jesus. For many, it was waste. For Judas, it was waste. And for many others, it was pure waste. But for Mary, it was her love. And Jesus had a word of appreciation. Jesus appreciated her. Jesus defended her. I think of a boy who, when he was working in a bank with a huge big salary, resigned his job and joined to become priest. Many people asked, what about your education? What about your banking skills? Is that not a waste? Next year he is going to be ordained. For many, that was waste. But for that boy, that was his act of love for God. St. Paul, writing to the Philippians, says, but once I found him, all those things that I considered as profit, I now reckon as lost for the sake of Christ. Indeed, I count everything as loss for the surpassing worth of knowing Christ Jesus. When we find the true love in Christ, we are able to let go many things that we consider today as profitable, and we are able to do what the world may consider foolish. Jesus said that parable of a man who found the pearl. When he found the pearl, he was ready to sell everything to possess that pearl. A question that we need to ask ourselves in the light of the gospel today is this: why do I love Christ? Do I love Christ for some selfish, private motive? Do I love Christ that I may get something? We need to admit most of the time that is the way many of us love Christ. We love Christ that we may pass the exam. We love Christ that we may get a financial blessing. We love Christ because we may get a good job, that we may have peace in our family. Lots of selfish reasons are there. During this Holy Week, let us once again purify our motive. Let us love Christ for Christ's sake, because he has loved us, because he has given his life for us, because he died on the cross for us. Let us learn to love Jesus as Mary loved, without counting the cost. Mary becomes a perfect example of what a disciple should be, loving Christ without counting the cost. So also we have another person in the gospel today, Judas. A second personality we can reflect from the gospel passage is Judas. Judas said, why are you wasting this? Why don't you sell and give that money to the poor? And then St. John adds one more sentence there. He did not say that because he loved the poor, but because he was keeping the money back, and from that money back he used to steal. Judas, though he was with Christ, was a dishonest person. He was a hypocrite. In the sight of the world, in the sight of everyone, a disciple, but he had his own selfish, private motives. He was stealing from the money back. And he thought, if this money comes to the money back, he can get a share. Many a times we think of Judas, who betrayed Jesus. It all began there, because he had a double personality. He was a cheater. He was cheating from the very beginning. We think of Peter, who denied Jesus, but cried, wept, and came back, because that was once. When he denied Jesus, his heart or his conscience pricked, and he wept and came back. But Judas was doing this repeatedly. He was dishonest always, even though he was working with Jesus, even though he was listening to Jesus' teachings. He was dishonest, he was fraud, and as a result, even when he betrayed Jesus, he could not come back. I believe Judas could not repent because of this habitual sin of cheating and being dishonest, or his habit of being dishonest, or his habit of being a double-minded or double personality. What sort of a personality do we have? Are we appearing to be good people before others, but in our heart, inside, are we dishonest? Are we hypocrites? Sisters and brothers, as we enter into this Holy Week, let us examine ourselves gently before God, honestly, and see, do we have the attitude of Mary, who loved Jesus with a pure love, or are we loving Jesus for our selfish reasons? Are we like Mary or are we like Judas? Let's make a prayer. Heavenly Father, as we enter into this season, into this week of Holy Week, we pray very specially that we may have the grace to examine ourselves honestly and purge ourselves with the precious blood of Christ, purify ourselves with the precious blood of Christ, that we may be made new, that we may become truly disciples of Christ. Mary, our beloved mother, seeking your prayers, we pray together. Hail Mary,
full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Look graciously, O Lord, upon the sacred mysteries we celebrate here, and may what you have mercifully provided to cancel the judgment we incurred bear for us fruit in eternal life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For the days of his saving passion and the glorious resurrections are approaching, by which the pride of the ancient foe is vanquished and the mystery of our redemption in Christ is celebrated. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim,
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. May holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take these, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take these, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Lourdes Daniel, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint Dominic, Saint Francis, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body of Christ lead me to eternal life. May the blood of Christ lead me to eternal life.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Do not hide your face from me in the day of my distress. Turn your ear towards me on the day when I call. Speedily answer me. Let us pray. Visit your people, O Lord, we pray, and with ever watchful love, look upon the hearts dedicated to you by means of these sacred mysteries, so that under your protection, we may keep safe this remedy of eternal salvation, which by your mercy we have received through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May your protection, O Lord, we pray, defend the humble and keep ever safe those who trust in your mercy, that they may celebrate the Paschal festivities not only with bodily observance, but above all with purity of mind, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in the peace and joy of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Wish you all a very blessed day. God bless you.